The children's school's primary role is to facilitate research in developmental psychology and any related fields. The children's school has a whole wing of laboratories where faculty members conduct research. And our job is to have children available for that research, children ages 3, 4, and 5. Our other job is to help improve the research by helping the faculty members, graduate students, and their research teams to better understand children and think about the best ways to get the data that they want in order to answer the research questions that they have.
I have been working with the children's school conducting research studies here for about 14 years. It allowed me to do some unique studies that otherwise I wouldn't be able to do. For example, to conduct longitudinal studies where we can follow the same child over a period of time and ask the same child many different questions in many different situations.
In terms of the educators, primarily they're serving as models. People are coming here to observe, whether they're undergraduates or graduate students or professionals in the field, and the teachers are modeling best practice in early childhood education. We have a whole child approach, so our goals span the full range of development. We start with self-esteem and independence, interaction and cooperation, communication, discovery and exploration, physical capabilities, health and safety, and artistic expression and appreciation.
One of my very favorite things to do at the children's school is to be in what we call our make shop. And the make shop is where we do our making. Making can be tinkering, learning how to use hand tools, discovering how balls run down ramps and how, if you set them up different ways, what will happen. Lots of problem solving with many different kinds of tools. We've built circuits with young children, taken machines apart to see what's inside. So mostly it's an inquiry activity. The culture is about the love of learning, how we help the children get that love, and how we encourage the families to be a part of that.
My passion is designing and creating experiences that allow education to be, you know, more accessible to large groups of people, because most people don't have access to this rich early education environment that we provide here. And I would love to try to bring what I've learned from this school and put it out so more people can have it.
Based on what I've learned at the Dietrich College, I have taken those psychological approaches to now implement them here at the children's school. So kind of the psychological approaches I've learned about how to talk to children, how they behave, and what best aids them in their development are things that I've all used here when interacting with the children.
So for me as an educator, the benefits of being at the lab school are that we get to firsthand see some of the big ideas that are kind of coming out of the psychology part, and we can kind of take that research and work it into our daily activities and routines. When the three-year-olds are exploring the snap circuits, we set them out and we kind of just give them a little bit of time to engage independently, kind of discover how the snaps go together, kind of the physical constraints of the materials. So through this structure and discovery and guidance, the friends kind of learn what a snap circuit is and how electricity works. It's a really excellent discovery activity that the friends have.
In my 32 years, one of the things that has struck me the most about being part of a laboratory school is that everyone here is so supportive and so nurturing and willing at any moment to lend a hand, to help a family, to help a child. That's a really typical characteristic of laboratory schools. I've visited many of them through the Lab School Association, and I find that that's kind of central to the lab school community.
See you tomorrow. See you.